Frostcliff Tavern. Let's go say hello. Hope it's an actual tavern and not full of bandits.
You're gonna explore, aren't you? Take your time, I'll wait. I can use a break anyway.
Shut up and take a break without announcing it. Let's just look around for us before we start picking locks. Hi. Bye. A drunk guest.
Outlander. Isn't this nice?
Yeah, isn't it? Milram Star Searcher. People don't talk.
Welcome, welcome. What can I do for you?
Anything to drink?
Oh, a bit of this and that. The roast rabbit is really good. Take a look for yourself.
Was she selling?
Oh, a bit of this and that. The roast rabbit is really
good.
That's
me.
Take a look for yourself.
Was she selling these? Oh, never mind. And he's sneaking. He said, do not risk Martha's wrath. Cause you're straying the boy as a wayward wanderer, despising the path that is. We got up to 40 with sneak, right? The dreams that you seek in the deep red afterglow are as distant as they'll ever be.
Safe travels.
Thank you.
Alright, so now we have sneak 45, correct? She does have rhetoric books. Rhetoric. I'm at 86. So she has masters.
Walk blessed. Oh, a bit of this and that. The roast rabbit is really good. Take a look for yourself.
She doesn't sell the master books of the rhetoric, unfortunately. All right.
Safe travels.
There's a lot of people here who won't speak.
What?
What?
Well, Lucy says what?
Some people just don't know their path, my dame.
My dame. Fades away at the end of
the day. An outlander. Isn't this nice?
Okay. Where do the songs you sing come from?
It depends. Some of them are ancient and Relian traditions. Some have been written by famous bards, and some of them I've collected through my journeys. What would you like to hear?
The Song of Winter Sky.
Sure.
Sorry.
Ahoy.
I can't sing.
And just how exactly is that supposed to help us?
Bellathor Firestorm.
No, Lord blessed, madam.
Now where's my bag?
Here. Thank you for your services.
Jesus, why is that stuff so expensive?
My pleasure. What do you want?
A mark on this world. Wait a second. Speak with a young Eterna. What is this? In the Frostcliff Tavern, I saw a young Eterna having a conversation with a mercenary. The minstrel didn't seem very happy with the report of the mercenary. Perhaps I should offer her my help?
Do I know you?
Nope.
Not yet. I'm Topaz.
Ah. Well, I'm Esme. Esme Yaliyal. Can I help you with something?
Yaliyal. Who's that man, the one you were talking to?
Him? Oh, just another disappointment, I guess. Nothing you need to worry about.
Maybe I can help you?
Help me, huh? Very noble of you.
Not for the right price.
Why?
That man you were talking to before was talking about his pay.
Ah, so that's what this is all about. Well, I hate to disappoint, but I haven't exactly had the best of luck with sellswords. If it's a job you're looking for, look somewhere else.
Hey!
Him? Oh, just enough. Help me, huh? Why?
No particular reason, I just want to help.
Well, you just don't see a lot of helpfulness these days. Especially when there's nothing to be gained in return. Especially to a tramp.
Okay, that guy's very rude. A tramp?
Never mind. I don't want to be the self-pitying Eterna. This country is way better than Nayrim or Erezeel.
Well, that's just how he is. Always talking.
Well, just tell me what this is about, then we can see.
Huh. How's this? Before we go any further, you have a seat, and we play a couple of rounds of the Battle for Treyamar. I'll think over your offer in the meantime, and we'll let you know of my decision afterwards. What do you think?
Fine. I don't want to play a game. I'm going to lose to you. I know I am.
Well, then. Innkeep. 2 mugs of ale, please.
This involves ale.
Dealing?
Sure. I have no idea what I'm doing. No, definitely not max. I'm wagering 5. The wolf. The seraph. Your alliance displays a strength of 21. Do you want to roll the dice to boost the strength of your team? Doing so costs 2 pennies, which go directly to your opponent. Ugh. Should I? I have no idea what I'm doing. Sure. You have boosted the strength of your team by 8 points. Your strength now amounts to 29 points. Okay. The wolf, the spider, and the seraph again. Esme's team displays a strength of 17 points. Your team beats Esme's alliance. You won 9 pennies. Okay, now what? We're done?
Not bad. Come on, another round. We're not done yet.
Ugh. I don't wanna I wanna get on to whatever. 5 again. The priest, the archer, and the priest. I know it has something to do with the numbers. Displays a strength of 12. Oh yeah, because it adds up. Okay, I am boost the strength of my team. That was a lot lower than my first one. My strength now amounts to 20 points. 1 Oh, you stink at this. The rat, and the bear. Esme's team display a strength of 9 points, but Esme boosted them by 8. Well, it's still not as much as minus 20, I think. By doing so, Esme lost 0 pennies, which go directly to you. How is that fair? She lost 0 pennies? So her strength is 17. I win. Okay, can we end this now? I'm done.
Not my day. Ah, that was fun. Can't remember the last time I've played.
Well, now you can.
So, regarding your offer, does it still stand? I've thought on it, and I'd actually be glad for all the help I can get.
My offer stands. What do you need?
Well, I'm looking for someone. but let's talk at my camp, shall we? Elrond needs fodder, and he's been alone out there for way too long now.
Who's Elrond?
My Leorin.
Oh. You have a camp nearby?
Yeah, something like that. Come, follow me.
I'm not done looking around this place. I'll be there in a little bit. So you're playing the aged man. People don't have much to say.
Isn't this nice?
Yes, it's sweet indeed. I can pick adept, can I? Yeah. Ah. Hello.
Fades away at the end of the day. Ta-dum dum.
My safe return, trust in this. Less promise and stand firm. Once moonlight shines red onto the seas.
Some people just don't know their path.
Return a victory.
What the? My dame.
Blue banners in the sky, the teardrops.
Ah, damn it. I held that for way too long. The other way? Okay, this is very... tricky? Finally.
We're running from her eyes, yet she thought, if only I believe time will bring him safely back to me when the red moon casts its light. His ghost travels through the night.
There's really nothing in here.
Until he reaches the old hill. There she kneels before his grave. Where their love had once been born. And he caresses her face. Yet she feels not his embrace. Dark and red glows the winter's night.
Apprentice lock. This one should be a lot easier. Maris, you're gonna get me in trouble. Thirty-seven coins, eh? Not bad. Alright, I'm done.
Step out into the cold.
Hello, Jespar. I can ask him how he's a hunter, but he's not a hunter. Farewell. Oh, here you are.
Come along. Here we are.
Your camp?
And yeah, this is where I live. Why don't you start a fire while I take care of Elrond?
I have to start a fire now?
Thank you.
Yeah, no problem.
So, I'll try to make this short. I'm here on Enderal because I'm looking for someone who left my life a while ago.
Okay.
How do they put it in these parts? My companion. Former companion, that is. Terra.
Lover? How long have you been in Enderal?
About a moon's turn now. I came with a trade ship from Kylai.
Interesting. I'm also an outsider. I'm from Nerim.
Nerim? Oh my. I understand why you fled then. But yeah, now that you mentioned it, you do have a slight accent.
Okay. What makes you think that she's here in Enderal?
A letter I received a while ago. Back then I was still with my clan, near Yunil Yar. It came by Myrid Courier, which was more than unusual. Just like myself, Terra was a minstrel. And, as you might know, money is always sparse among our kind.
Your clan?
Minstrel groups, bards, acrobats, magicians, you name it.
I'm a magician. So I'm guessing the letter was from Terra. What did it say?
You guess right. She said that she was planning to do something. Something extremely stupid.
Really? Need to be a bit more specific than that. What was it that she wanted to do?
All right. I think I need to go back a little. You know, Terra has always been somewhat complicated. Introverted. Wary of others.
In this
If you didn't
profession?
Know her, you'd have been inclined to think that she was arrogant.
So how can you be a performer yet be so introverted and stuff, but yet you fell in love with her?
Yeah, I did. Probably because I saw right away that her demeanor was a form of self-protection more than anything. Buried under that shell of ice was an extremely kind, vulnerable, and caring person. Anyway, what I'm getting at is that Terra has always had difficulty being happy. She had been through a lot, and it had broken her in some way. Every now and then, this black fog would come over her. Sometimes it was bearable. Sometimes it was so bad that she refused to leave her tent all day long.
What had she been through?
Doesn't matter.
Okay. I'm guessing her gloom was one of the reasons you separated?
One of the reasons, yeah. But there was something else that happened about 2 years ago. We had just finished a performance at a festival, and I had lost Terra in the crowd. When I found her again, she had this look on her face, as though the Seven Lightborn had just revealed themselves to her. She was hypnotized.
What happened?
Well, in that crowd, she had met a woman. She had worn a mask, like the other guests at the ball, and according to Terra, she had approached her right after our performance. She... how should I put it? She had told her that she had a solution for Terra's problem. For the black fog.
She describe that woman? What did she look like?
According to Terra, she wore a white robe and a veil. Or was it gray? I'm not sure, it's been so long.
So a solution for her problem. What kind of solution?
Yeah. I quickly forgot about the whole thing, and I thought Terra had too. But the letter proved me wrong. Her encounter with that woman. I had never let go of her. Never.
So that's why she came to Enderal? To follow the woman's trail?
Yeah. And some of the things she said in that letter, they scared me. Because they sounded so final. I don't know. It's probably madness that I'm even here. I mean, she's a grown woman, and we're not even companions anymore. But still, when I read those lines, everything inside me froze. As though I was watching her walk towards an abyss, and wasn't able to stop her.
Why exactly did you break up?
That's complicated. I'd rather not talk about it.
You must talk about it, damn you. I think I might have met that veiled woman Tara was talking about. Maybe. I don't... There must be more than one veiled woman out there, but I guess I might have met her. In the beginning of... Enderal.
What? When? How?
We came to Enderal as stowaways. The veiled woman was on that ship, too, and gave us away to the captain. It cost my friend his life.
His by the name of the sun. I'm so sorry. Well, who is she, then? Do you have any idea?
Nope. Whatever she is involved in something far bigger than ourselves.
Something bigger, huh? I'm guessing you're talking about this red madness, aren't you?
Could be.
Either way, I suppose the big questions will have to wait. First, we need to find Tara.
Do you have that letter with you? I'd like to take a look.
Take a look? I don't know where I put it. I'm sorry. Maybe later.
She doesn't want to show us the letter. You know exactly where it is. Whatever. Do you have any leads?
Just one. And according to that mercenary I talked to in the tavern, it's leading nowhere. Even though I can't help but feel as though he was sloppy.
I do need money for my endeavors. Please, before we take this any further, how much are you paying me? She said minstrels don't have much.
What? Oh, right. I can offer you 250 pennies. Once you've found something we can go on.
Yeah, you
if
just
we,
like it.
I mean, if I manage to find Tara, I can even give you a gem. That should compensate you for your efforts.
Okay. Tell me about this lead. I'll look into it.
All right. My only clue so far is the name of the ship on which Tara set over from Kyle. The Morning Dew. It was a trade vessel whose crew was mad enough to sail the Red Sea despite the wars.
Kyle.
When I came here, the Morning Dew had just set sail again.
Drew.
But I wasn't able to find anyone with information on Tara's whereabouts.
The Morning Dew? That's the name of the ship I arrived on.
Really?
Oh, then, it is.
Did you see Tara? A young Eterna. Black hair, blue eyes?
Nope. I'm afraid of that. The Morning Dew sets sail again. How is it still a lead?
Well, according to the mercenary, the ship ran aground up north. If that's true, and if we get lucky, we might be able to find something in the captain's chambers that could help us. A logbook, a list of passengers, something like that. Here. This is where the ship ran aground, apparently.
Huh? Guess you're marking my map? Fair enough. I'll go there and see what I can find.
Thank you. I appreciate it. How about a sip of spiced wine before you leave? A turn of specialty.
Sure.
All right. One moment.
We got two likes and a dislike. Find the wreck of the Morning Dew and search for hints and stuff.
What is it? What is it?
It's you doing calisthenics.
Yes?
let's see. After a long conversation by the campfire, I was told by Esme that she is searching for her companion Tara. She has supposedly crossed the sea to Enderal on a ship called the Morning Dew. Okay, which can be one or two words, either one. Unfortunately, the ship sunk shortly on its continuation of its journey near the shores around the Frostcliff Mountains. I am supposed to search you for clues concerning Tara's whereabouts. Find the wreck of the Morning Dew and search for hints. Yeah, Tara's whereabouts. Okay, it's very tough. Thing. I don't have that active. I guess over here. It's moving me there, it's just there's no... Oh, here it is. Okay. Well, we're not going there yet. That's pretty far from where we are. We're just supposed to go do this thing with Constantine. It was cool finding this place, nonetheless.
Eager to explore, aren't you? Take your time, I'll wait. I can use a break anyway.
Shush over there. I want to see the, is this it right here? Yeah, it has to be. The Myra Tower.
Never walk back on.
Hello.
From the ancient man's abode.
Ugh, blazes. Sorry. I know. I can't sing.
Got free crusty bread here. And money. How could you sleep here in this? You'd be better off putting the bed down here. So you're protected from by the elements. Pardon me. Sorry. Alright. I think there's rocks in the way over there. Yeah. Oh, where does that thing go? I'm probably supposed to find something. One of these eggs. So I think we have to loop around, actually. Die, bunny! Damn, these rocks. Oh, pretty. Oh, look at that! Oh, this is gonna hurt us, isn't it? This stuff. Jespar? You stopped.
And that's it. The Crystal Forest. Beautiful, isn't it? The temple should just be a few miles up the hill.
Okay. Commander Aaron called the temple the Living Temple. Why is that?
Oh, it's an old legend. Apparently this temple has some kind of consciousness.
Don't punch
me. So to speak. That's also the reason for the weird vegetation around here.
Oh. 9 out of 40. Okay, let's get going.
Yep.
Yep. Can I? Yeah. Oh. We've got a guardian of sorts. Well, is there two of them? I got a fire arrow, okay. Crystal elemental. One down. Interesting. Oh, I gotta charge this stuff. Empty. Disappointing. Oh, there's something over there. Crystal Spectre. I damaged it a little bit. And a little bit more. I'm slowly killing the thing. One more might do it. Oh, one more. Cool. I'll check out that dungeon another time. All right, we still need him. Ancestral spirit. Ectoplasm and ghost wrapping. Yeah, I don't think that works. It's like, wow, I'll tell you. Eat my green death. Closer? Yes, we are. checking because chest bar is not on my little meter anymore. Oh, was it the Orbaya who was on my meter? Oh, wow. What felled that great beast? Oh.
Now a good pipe.
Not attacking? Nope.
That was quicker than expected. Did you find the gem?
So it took me longer than expected to meet you at, what do you call it? Fogville. But this was quicker than expected, but, yes.
Show me. Well, I'll be damned, that's the one. Then I suppose it's time for me to tell you some things about the temple.
Okay.
Maybe you've already heard the Enderalian legend about this place. It's said that this temple is alive, and that the entire forest is some kind of sensory organ of it.
Really?
Heareth his whispers, sung from the trees, dreadeth his gaze, blah blah blah, you get the idea. Though most folk legends are superstitious nonsense, this one has a true core. The temple does indeed have a consciousness of some sort. That has, however, less to do with some suicidal lover's tragic fates, but with a Pyrian defense mechanism. The Stone Heart.
Stone Heart. So that makes a temple come alive? How does that work?
It works because the Pyrians found a way to conjoin something immaterial with a human soul. That doesn't need to be a building like it is here. It can also be a sword or an amulet. The bound ones, as those whose consciousness was transferred were called, suffered atrocious pain during the ritual. But when it worked, they practically achieved immortality.
Well, that's consoling.
It's a terrible fate, yes. But we all know that with the right religious blathering, humans can be convinced to do just about anything.
Probably.
However, don't get the wrong idea. These bindings were unusual. Not every Pyrian had a relative living in his frying pan, so to speak. Only a very few Arcanists, mainly those of the Ishian caste, were able to perform them. In other words, bound places or objects were extremely rare.
Okay.
This temple is one of them.
So in other words, there's a Pyrian consciousness resting in that temple.
I doubt that it's resting. Witnessing the downfall of one's own civilization, and since then being forced to hang around in an extinct world, hardly has a positive effect on one's sanity. But we'll see. Go ahead, put the gem in the socket over there.